Well, welcome back, Real Hills fans. Something looks weird on your computer screens, I know. My usually reliable co-host, Blake McGee, is obviously not here. The rigors of a long season and March Madness in general have prevented him from being here. In anticipation that he may not be able to make it back, you, the viewer, will be able to participate in selecting the next co-host of the Real Heels Report. Your options in this all-important vote are A, Geraldo Rivera, legend in the biz. B, Brad Daughtery. I think he's got some broadcasting experience, and it's always great to have a Carolina alum on the show. C, Erin Andrews, always popular with the fans. Or D, Jeff Martin, Tar Heel fan extraordinaire. You guys vote, and the results of your vote will help us select the next co-host, and you'll see them with a recap of the first round games in Raleigh. Getting back to the action, it's been a little while since we've been to you, and we want to go ahead and talk about that Duke victory, and of course give out the Woody Award. It was a great game. We knew we were going to win from the last time we played them. Roy did a great job. The team did a great job. As you've been waiting for, and we've gotten those emails, we know, the Woody Award for Duke. So you guys saw the game. He had a pretty significant dunk on Greg Paulus. You've seen the highlights 1,000 times. Danny Green, for you, Woody Award winner Danny Green, you get your choice of tea bags. If you want to go with the traditional green tea, we have those here for you. If you're feeling frisky, you can try the white tea. Island Mango Peach Flavored Lipton's. Either way, big dunk, great game, enjoy the teabags. We're getting ready to look at some highlights from the ACC Tournament. Of course, Carolina won that back-to-back ACC Championships. Before we do that, how about a quick word from the sponsor, and then to the highlights. It's pretty simple. If I say sell 4,000 shares, I mean sell 4,000 shares. Now do it! Bulls and Bears getting you down. What about the Cubbies? Listen, if you want stock advice, read the Wall Street Journal. If you want to know what's going on in the Tar Heel Nation, go to TarHeelForum.com. Click it.
Us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our show together, we're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Well,
don't you let nothing, nothing stand in your way. I want y'all to listen, listen
to every word I say, every word I say.
Ain't no stopping us now.
We're on the move.
Ain't no stopping us now.
And if you're trying to make it, they only push you aside. They really don't have nowhere to go. Ask them where they're going, they don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're gonna put our show together, gonna polish up our act. Well,
And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore.
Don't you let nothing, nothing stand in your way. I want y'all to listen, listen to every word I say, every word I say. No, no, no.
We're moving.
Tournament Woody Award winners, of course, sponsored by TarHeelForum.com. Click it. Co-Woody Award winners for the ACC Tournament. Number one, Mr. Wayne Ellington. Big performance, made big buckets, played great defense, big rebounds. For you, my friend, the classic 1993 VHS March of the Tar Heels. Or, if you want to go to more recent times, how about March to the Arch? Story of the 2005 Tar Heel Championship. The other Co-Woody Award winner, Tyler Hansbrough, big shot to send Virginia Tech packing. Great performances all three games. It's been in the news. Tyler's jersey is going to be retired. And that means this special DVD is going to have to be updated. This is Jersey in the Rafters. Tyler, yours will absolutely be there. So check this out if you want to see who your jersey is going to be sitting next to. So congratulations. We finished the season at 33-2, and that is fantastic. We are the number one seed in the East, starting off playing in Raleigh at the RBC Center, place we're very familiar with, place where we've had plenty of success as well. Now to get all your tips on bracketology, it's time to call Jed Drake.
All right, well, it's that time again. It's March Madness. Everybody's got their brackets. They're filling them out. They want to win that money in the office pool. So I'm going to give you the four keys to bracketology. And today, bracketology keys are brought to you by TarHeelForum.com. Go check it out. They have write-ups on the games. You can even find the latest Real Heels reports. Number one, go with your gut instinct. Don't do a lot of over-analyzing on these things. Fill it out quickly and stick with it. Number two, if you do want to get cute in the first round and pick some upsets, go for it. Some good ones to look at are the 12-5 matchup. Call a few upsets. Don't let that team advance past the second round. Thirdly, there's never been four number one seeds in the Final Four, so take that into consideration. Last but not least, this will absolutely guarantee you a win. You'll win that money on that last line right in the middle of your bracket. Go ahead and write down the North Carolina Tar Heels, baby. Going all the way this year, San Antonio, it's ours. Go Heels.
This final point is the most important point in bracketology. If you are any kind of Tar Heel fan, you will have filled in Carolina to win it all. We're not going to look ahead. We know we're taking on Mount St. Mary's in the first game, but we're not going to make any predictions about who we're playing in the second game because we're taking this tournament one game at a time. But we will be back with you next week with a recap of the first round of games in Raleigh. Hope that we see you there, and hopefully this weekend, we will be seeing a lot of Tyler Hansbrough.
Hansbrough gets an airborne, gets inside.
Because he's got the freshman out of the freshman crowd.
Goes up again. Scores the tie.
Three.